Hey guys, welcome to Pastry Living. This is Aya. Today we're making very moist and soft classic vanilla cake that you can use for all the kinds of baking projects. So let's get started. First, as a prep, apply a thin layer of butter all around the pans and attach the cake liner on the bottom. In the bowl, add sugar, salt, soft butter, and half of the whole oil. And it's very important to whip really well here to create a softer, fluffier texture. So keep whipping it at high speed. And meanwhile, mix the rest of the dry ingredients, sifted cake flour, baking powder, and baking soda. And mix all the wet ingredients together. Beat it with the whisk. And the other half of the oil, milk, heavy cream, vinegar, and vanilla extract. And that's it, you just have to mix them. And let's go back to the butter. I usually whip for about 4 to 5 minutes. It is done when it looks so fluffy like this. It means it contains lots of air to help push the cake up in the oven. And add about half of the flour. Mix until it's evenly combined. And about half of the liquids. Mix slowly first and gradually speed up. And clean up the bowl and the petal to catch anything that was left. And add the rest of flour. And again, mix well until it's evenly incorporated. And add the rest of liquids. Again, mix slowly first because it can scatter everywhere. You can also divide in half if it's easier. And again, scrape off the bowl and petal to ensure everything is evenly incorporated. Speed up and keep mixing until it gets very smooth. We do not want any lumps of flour in the finished batter. Today I'm gonna make 2 layers, but you can also do like 3 layers or 4 layers. When it's baked enough, the top shoe bounces back very gently and check with the toothpick. It should come out clean when you insert it in the very center. Insert a small spatula or something similar around the cake to ensure that it's detached from the pans and flip gently. You can also bake amazing cupcakes using this recipe. With one batch of the recipe, you can make 2 dozen cupcakes. Today I made a half batch and made 12 cupcakes. Once the cake is completely cooled, cut off the surface to frost easier and also to level the cake. To frost the cupcakes and cakes, today I used my Swiss buttercream. It is so fluffy and stable. Compared to my sponge cake recipe, this cake is heavier and you can frost it easily with heavier frosting such as buttercream and ganache. Enjoy making cupcakes, birthday cake, and any other cake for your special occasion. This cake is so moist, silky, and soft. I shared how to make vanilla cake a while ago, like 4 years ago, but since then I tested many times and I feel this one is much better than the first one. It became my new favorite. Please try it out and let me know what you think.
We store this cake wrapped tightly so that it's not gonna get dried, or wrapped one time and put it in a Ziploc. So because this cake contains butter, once it's chilled completely in the fridge, the texture gets firmer. Today I use half oil and half butter, so it doesn't get firm as much as like pound cake. It'll taste great, but if you want to enjoy the softer, fluffier texture, I recommend just leaving it at the room temperature for some time. And lastly, I wanted to show the comparison of this cake with cake flour and all-purpose flour. With cake flour, it tastes silkier and moister. It's just a little bit different texture. The difference is not as big as like a sponge cake. I know that some of you can't get cake flour in your area. So in that case, use all-purpose flour and you can still make amazing vanilla cake. Haven't checked out yet? Please check out my blog. Every time I post a video here, I write the post about the recipe as well. And there you can get the printable recipe and the written steps. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Enjoy pastry living and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.